Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you in the video lecture series on the subject Internal Combustion Engine. And this is the first lecture on the Internal Combustion Engine. Before we begin, we have to recall the basics of thermodynamics and fuels and combustion. So, we studied fuels and combustion chemistry, or sometimes in the thermodynamics also there is a chapter fuels and combustion to calculate the air fuel ratio, excess air, and the chemical combustion equation, the analysis of amount of air required, chemical equation that we studied. Engineering thermodynamics, the system concept, calculation of power, work done, and the heat transfer during a particular process, everything we studied. So, the basic knowledge on the engineering thermodynamics and fuels and combustion that is required for internal combustion engine. And the topic for this particular first lecture, we are going to study about the engine components, engine terminologies, and engine classification. And the learning outcome for this lecture, first lecture, the student will be able to identify the engine components. The student will be able to define the engine terminologies, and the student will be able to classify the internal combustion engine. So, first the heat engine, we define heat engine. A heat engine is a device which converts the chemical energy of the fuel into thermal energy and in turn into mechanical energy. So, engine, heat engine, which is taking the chemical energy of the fuel as an input, and it produces mechanical energy. And the heat engine is further classified into internal combustion engine and external combustion engine. So, in the internal combustion engine, the combustion of the fuel is taking place inside the engine cylinder. In the external combustion engine, the combustion of the fuel is taking place outside the engine. So, there is a separate place where the burning of the fuel is taking place, the heat is produced, that heat is given, taken into the engine. So, the burning is taking place outside the engine cylinder, is called as external combustion engine. The internal combustion engine, they are further, we have four examples of the internal combustion engine: open cycle gas turbine, Wankel engine, rotary engine, Wankel engine, gasoline engine, diesel engine, gasoline engine, petrol engine, gas engine, and diesel engine. And external combustion engine, we have the steam engine, steam turbine, Stirling engine, closed cycle gas turbine. So, the steam turbine, the steam is produced in the boiler, and the steam engine also, the steam is produced in the boiler, which is outside the steam engine or the steam turbine, and the steam, hot steam is taken into the steam engine and the steam turbine to produce the mechanical power. The Stirling engine, so from the external source, we are supplying the heat energy to the system. And the closed cycle gas turbine, again from the external source, we are supplying the heat to the and the air. And look at the diagram. So, the engine, various engine components, a single cylinder engine, there are many components. Look at the line diagram, there are many components. You look into the diagram for a few seconds, identify the parts, or even you can take the drawing of the engine components. So, the various components what you identified, so starting with the cylinder, piston, so cylinder is a cylindrical barrel, piston is reciprocating inside the engine cylinder, and we have a connecting rod, and the connecting rod is connected to the piston by means of gudgeon pin or wrist pin, and the other end of the connecting rod we have the crank pin, so which is connected to the crank, and you have a crankshaft, so about the crankshaft, the crank is rotating and the connecting rod is oscillating, and the piston is reciprocating inside the engine cylinder. And at the top of the cylinder, we have the cylinder head. So, the cover is called a cylinder head, and we take intake or the suction manifold, exhaust manifold. So, here we have the suction valve, and in the exhaust manifold, we have the exhaust valve. So, these are all the various components. And we have other terminologies like top dead center or the TDC, bottom dead center or the BDC. And the distance between these two is called as stroke length. Distance between the TDC and BDC is called as stroke volume. and the diameter is given by the bore. Bore is the diameter of the cylinder. And we discuss the components one by one. Cylinder. So this is the cylindrical component. As the name implies, it is a cylindrical vessel or the space in which the piston makes a reciprocating motion. So piston is reciprocating inside the engine cylinder. The varying volume created in the cylinder during the operations of the engine is filled with the working fluid and subjected to different thermodynamic processes. So the gas is taken into the air is taken into the engine cylinder, or air fuel mixture is taken into the engine cylinder, and it undergoes to different processes, thermodynamic processes, to produce the work. The cylinder is supported by the cylinder block. So the cylinder block is supporting the cylinder. The second component is piston. So it is also a cylindrical component fitted to the cylinder, forming the moving boundary of the combustion system. It fits perfectly into the cylinder, providing a gasketed space with the piston rings and the lubricant. So at the top of the piston, we have the piston rings. The piston rings provides the seal between the gases and the cylinder block. So the tightly fitted, and it is reciprocating. It forms the first link of transmitting gas force into output shaft. So there are different links. Four bar mechanism we studied. So four bar mechanism is typically applicable for engine, IC engine, for converting the heat energy of the gas into mechanical power. And third component is the combustion chamber. So the space enclosed in the upper part of the cylinder. So for you take this diagram. So this is the combustion chamber. So the cylinder block and the piston, above the piston and within the cylinder, this space is called as combustion chamber, where the burning of the fuel is taking place. So the combustion chamber, the space enclosed in the upper part of the cylinder by the cylinder head and the piston top during the combustion process, is called as combustion chamber. The combustion of the fuel and the consequent release of thermal energy results in the building up pressure in the part of the cylinder. So the combustion is taking place, and the force is acting on the top of the piston, which makes the piston to move downward. So intake manifold, the pipe which connects the intake system to the inlet valve of the engine, through which air or air fuel mixture is drawn into the engine cylinder. So through the, it is called as intake manifold. So the, there is a pipeline connecting the intake valve and the outside. So through the intake manifold, we are taking air or air fuel mixture into the engine cylinder. Exhaust manifold, again it is also a pipe which connects the exhaust system and to the exhaust valve of the engine, through which the product of combustion escapes into the atmosphere, called exhaust manifold. So this is also a pipe connecting the to let out the burnt gases to the atmosphere. Intake and inlet and the exhaust valve. The valve, commonly mushroom shaped puppet type, they are provided either on the cylinder head or on the side of the cylinder for regulating the charge coming into the cylinder, that is inlet valve, and for discharging the product of combustion, exhaust valve, from the cylinder. So this is of mushroom shape. So the shape of the valve, intake valve and the exhaust valve, they are in the mushroom shape. And spark plug. So it is a component initiate the combustion of the process in the case of spark ignition engine, that is petrol engine, and it is usually located at the top of the cylinder head. And the fuel injector, this is the component mounted on the cylinder head of a compression ignition engine, that is diesel engine, so to inject the fuel at the end of the compression stroke. So fuel injector is injecting the fuel. In the case of petrol engine, so there is a component called a carburetor, which produces air fuel mixture. Connecting rod, it connects the piston and the crankshaft and transmit the gas force from the piston to the crankshaft. And the crankshaft, it converts the reciprocating motion of the piston into useful rotary motion of the output shaft. The crankshaft of the single cylinder engine, there is a pair of crank arm for and balance weight. The balance weights are provided for static and dynamic balance of the rotating system. The crankshaft is enclosed in the crankcase. Piston rings, so this is at the top of the piston, we have the piston rings. The piston rings fitted into the slot around the piston. It provides tight seal between piston and the cylinder wall, thus preventing the leakage of the combustion gases. So the combustion chamber, so the there is a possibility, because of the low pressure difference, there is a possibility of leaking of combustion gases to the crankcase or outside. So that is prevented by the piston rings. Gudgeon pin, it forms a link between small end of the connecting rod and the piston. So this is the pin used to connect the connecting rod and the top of the and the piston. Camshaft, so camshaft is also and the associated parts control the opening and the closing of the two valves. We have inlet valve, the exhaust valve. Their valves are actuated by the cam. The associated parts are push rod, rocker arm, and valve spring tappet. The shaft also provides the drive for the ignition system. The camshaft is driven by the crankshaft through the timing gear. So there is a timing gear connecting the camshaft and the crankshaft, and the camshaft is rotating half of the speed of the crankshaft. So when the crankshaft is rotating 2 revolutions, and the camshaft will be rotating 1 revolution. Cams, so they are made up of integral part of the camshaft, are designed in the such a way that open at the correct timing and keep them open for the necessary duration. So the cams are integral part of the camshaft, which provide so the force for opening and closing of the two valves. And flywheel, so in all the engine we have a flywheel. The flywheel is for to have a uniform torque on the angular velocity on the shaft. So net torque imparted to the crankshaft during one completed cycle of operation of the engine fluctuates, causing a change of angular velocity of the shaft. In order to achieve uniform torque and inertia mass in the form, a wheel is attached to the output shaft, and this wheel is called as flywheel. The variation of net torque decreases with the increase in the number of cylinders in the engine, and thereby size of the flywheel becomes smaller. So for a higher capacity engine, that means the single cylinder engine will have a larger flywheel, whereas the multi cylinder engine will have a smaller flywheel. So when the power of the engine is increasing, the size of the flywheel will decrease. That is the idea. So flywheel, it provides a uniform angular torque on the shaft, so which is required for balancing purpose of the crankshaft of the engine. And this is the cylinder block. So this is a cylinder block for the 4-cylinder engine. So this is the cylindrical space in which the piston is reciprocating. So this is the piston connected to the connecting rod. So the for connecting rod, there are two ends. Small end is connected to the top of this piston, and the big end is connected to the crank. And this is the crankshaft. So where you have the big end of the connecting rod is connected here, and this is called as balancing web or balancing weight. And this wheel is called as time. I mean, actually, this is the flywheel, which is also acting as a the starting motor gear. So here we are attaching the starting motor to start the engine. And this is what the valve actuating mechanism. So we have a cam. So here we have the cam here in the camshaft. So the cam is actuating the. This is the crankshaft. We have the camshaft. So this is the cam which is rotating, and the cam is actuating, pushing the push rod. So here we have the rocker arm. So this is the hinge of the rocker arm. So this is fluctuating. When the pushing rod is moving in the upward direction, the other end of the rocker arm will push the valve. So this is the valve. Actually, this is the mushroom shape of the valve. And the valve, against this spring force, the valve will move downward, which will open the space. So for admitting the air filled mixture or air into the engine cylinder. Similarly, once the cam comes to this position, and the valve will be automatically closed. And this is a spark plug attached to the petrol engine for producing spark. So look at the spark plug. So the threaded portion is attached to the cylinder head, and there are two electrodes here, and the current is supplied here. So through the electrode, the spark is produced at the correct timing. And this is the fuel injector, so used for injecting diesel in the case of diesel engine or compression ignition engine. And this is the connecting rod. So the big end of the connecting rod, it is attached to the crankshaft. This is the small end of the connecting rod, which is attached to the piston. So we will be studying about the fuel injector, spark plug, valve actuating mechanism in detail in the later stage. And these are all the list of engine parts and material used for manufacturing. So cylinder, it may be cast iron or alloy steel, depending on the power and depending on the type of the fuel and the power produced, heat generator in the combustion process. Cylinder head, cast iron or aluminium alloy. piston cast iron or aluminium alloy, piston ring silicon cast iron, wrist pin steel, valves alloy steel, connecting rod steel, crankshaft alloy steel or SG iron, crankcase aluminium alloy, steel or cast iron, cylinder liner cast iron, nickel alloy steel, and bearing white metal or leaded bronze. These are all the material used for various components of engine. And look at this diagram. So we go into the closure. For the various calculations, we require these details. So to the important details here. So the top dead center, bottom dead center, stroke volume, clearance volume, and the piston diameter. So these are all the important components. So the various terminologies. First is cylinder bore. The nominal inner diameter of the working cylinder is called a cylinder bore, and it is designated by letter D. It is usually expressed in millimeter. And piston area, at the area of the circle of the diameter equal to the cylinder bore. So the cross sectional area of the piston, or the top surface area of the piston. So it is based on the diameter of the cylinder, because diameter of the cylinder is equal to diameter of the piston. So the area of the circle of diameter equal to the cylinder bore is called as piston area, and it is designated by letter A, and it is usually measured in square centimeter. Stroke length or stroke, simply stroke, the nominal distance through which the working piston moves between successive reversal of its direction of motion is called as stroke, and it is designated by the letter L, expressed in millimeter. Simply the distance between TDC and BDC is called as stroke length or simply stroke. And dead center. So we have two dead center, top dead center, the bottom dead center. The exact definition of the dead center: the position of the working piston and the moving parts which are mechanically connected to it at a moment when the direction of the piston motion is reversed at the either end of the stroke is called as dead center. So the piston direction of motion is reversed. So at the top there is a point where it is getting reversed, at the bottom there is a point which is getting reversed. The top center is called as top dead center, and the bottom point is called as bottom dead center. So the TDC is the dead center when the piston is farthest from the crankshaft, and BDC is the dead center when the piston is nearest to the crankshaft. And displacement volume, swept volume or the stroke volume, VS, is the nominal volume swept by the piston when traveling from one dead center to the another dead center. It is called as displacement volume. So the volume between BDC to TDC is called as swept volume. It is expressed in cubic centimeter. So VS equal to pi by 4 d square into L. So pi by 4 d square is the cross-sectional area of the piston or a cylinder, and L is the length of the stroke. And the clearance volume, the nominal volume of the combustion chamber above the piston when it is at the top dead center is called as clearance volume. It is designated by VC and expressed in cubic centimeter. So clearance volume, swept volume. So these two volumes are used to calculate the compression ratio. So this is important parameter for the power calculation of the engine, compression ratio. It is ratio of the total cylinder volume when the piston is at the bottom dead center to the clearance volume is designated by the letter R. R is ratio of VS plus VC divided by VC. So VS is the swept volume or the stroke volume, VC is the clearance volume. So these are all the terminologies for engine, in the internal combustion engine. And the classification of internal combustion engine. So there are many types of engine. So we group the engine in different heading. So the first heading, based on the number of strokes. So this may be 4-stroke cycle engine or 2-stroke cycle engine. Normally the 4-stroke cycle engine are high power engine, and 2-stroke cycle engines are low power engine. According to the cycle of operation, auto cycle engine, diesel cycle engine. So auto cycle engine, it is a basic theoretical cycle for petrol engine. And diesel cycle engine is a diesel engine. So we studied the auto cycle and the diesel cycle earlier in the gas power cycle. According to the type of fuel used, engine using volatile liquid fuel like gasoline, alcohol, kerosene. So gasoline is the petrol or gas. Engine using gaseous fuel like natural gas, petroleum gas, blast furnace gas, an engine using solid fuel like charcoal and powdered coal. So olden days we are using powdered coal for engine operation. Nowadays we are using only the petroleum product. Engine using viscous fuel like diesel oil, and the engine using dual fuel. So dual fuel is two fuels. So starting the engine with the petrol and running with the kerosene. Some of the engine, they are starting with the petrol and running with kerosene. That is called as dual fuel engine. According to the method of charging, so how the air fuel mixture or air is admitted into the engine cylinder, that is what charging. So naturally aspirated engine or supercharged engine. All the engine operating at the ground level, they are naturally aspirated engine. So the air vehicle, helicopter, aeroplane, they are supercharged, they have supercharged engine. Nowadays in the ground vehicle also they have the supercharger. So there are some of the four wheeler, the car or four wheeler, they are given the adjective turbo engine. So turbo means turbocharged engine. That is a type of supercharging, adding more amount of air in a particular working stroke. That is what called a supercharging or turbocharging. So there are two types of engine, naturally aspirated engine or a supercharged engine. According to the type of ignition, so this is spark ignition engine or compression ignition engine. Spark ignition engine is petrol engine. So a spark is produced to initiate the combustion of the fuel, and the compression ignition engine is a diesel engine. So at the end of the compression, the fuel is injected. Using the air temperature, the combustion of the fuel starts. Ignition is the beginning of combustion process. According to the cooling method, air cooled engine or water cooled engine. And according to the governing method, it may be hit and miss governed engine or quality governing engine. According to the speed of the engine, low speed engine, medium speed engine, high speed engine. So all the race cars, they are high speed engine. So low speed engine, the heavy duty vehicle running at 1500 rpm, 900 rpm, 800 rpm, they are the low speed engine. And medium speed engine, above 1000 rpm speed. According to the use, stationary engine, portable engine, marine engine, automobile engine, aero engine. Stationary engine, they are used for the power generation. Portable engine, so they are also used for the agricultural purposes or again for power generation. Marine engine used in the ship. Automobile engine used in the all types of automobile. Aero engines, they are used in the aeroplane or air vehicle. According to the number of cylinder, this may be single cylinder engine or multi cylinder engine. According to the cylinder arrangement, so inline engine, V engine, opposed piston engine, opposed cylinder engine, radial engine. So inline engine and V engine, they are used in the ground vehicle. Radial engine, earlier we were using it for the helicopter or the aeroplane engine. So this is what inline. The cylinders are arranged in line. That is called as inline engine. A six cylinder inline engine. And this is what the V engine. So the cylinder arrangement is in the form of V. And this is the opposed piston. Look at here. There are four pistons in operation. So here we have two pistons and a spark plug at the center. Here we have two pistons and the spark plug at the center. So this is opposed piston engine. This is opposed cylinder engine. So we have the cylinder. So here one cylinder, we have the opposed cylinder engine. And this is what radial engine used in the helicopter. So we stop here and we have a reflection spot. So from the lecture, from your observation, you write down the topic or terms, what are all you remember. Write down, you take few seconds of time. Take a pencil and paper, write down the terms you are familiar from this lecture or the topic terms which you remember from the lecture. At least minimum 5. So if your list is falling under this, so you are good. Cylinder, cylinder head, piston, connecting rod, crankshaft, flywheel, spark plug, fuel injector, gudgeon pin, top dead center, bottom dead center, bore, stroke, clearance volume, shaft volume, inlet valve, exhaust valve, compression ratio, cam, petrol engine, diesel engine, marine engine, radial engine, V engine, automobile engine, supercharged engine, four stroke cycle engine, two stroke cycle engine, aero engine. So if you have any minimum five of this, you are good listener. And These are all the reference book I used for the preparing the slides. So I have written a book on thermal engineering. So thermal engineering by K. Kannan. So V. Ganesan, internal combustion engine. Gill and Smith, fundamentals of internal combustion engine. John B. Haywood, fundamentals of internal combustion engine. K. Rajput, thermal engineering. P. L. Barani, thermal engineering. You can refer to it for additional information. So thank you for watching. So please post your comments after seeing the video in the YouTube video itself. There is a comment box. You click the comment box. If you have any comments, you just post your comments for improvement of the video lectures. You subscribe the YouTube channel so that you will get the updated video. I have uploaded more than 160 videos on the thermal engineering subject, and I have uploaded the lectures on the GATE question paper solution for the GATE question paper. That will be useful for your better learning and to pass in the GATE examination. So you can contact me through my mail ID or through the WhatsApp number. So thank you for watching. We'll meet again.